Oh! Who invited all of you over tonight? Welcome to Cooking with Maddie V. My name is Bob, and I have some guests. Actually, my name is Matt Facchino. I'm originally from Queens, New York, and I live in Ahwatukee, Arizona. Ahwatukee is an Indian name, and it means stuck-up white people. But other than that, I have some guests here tonight. First of all, my lovely wife, Doreen. Say hello, Doreen.
Hi, Doreen.
My sister-in-law, just as beautiful because they're twins. Say hello, darling.
Hello.
And finally, my executive producer, editor, and the lady behind the camera, Haley. Say hello, Haley.
Hello, Haley.
All right, let's get it going. First of all, tonight's recipe is going to be a world-famous recipe eaten all around the world. It is called linguine and shrimp in a lemon cream sauce. Very simple, very easy to make. Now, first, like I said, we live in Arizona. It has been so hot in Arizona, I'm thinking, what are we going to drink tonight? The perfect recipe. We have a white sangria, very popular in Spain and Northern Italy. So, what we have here is strawberries, oranges, and peaches. Freshly cut. Making a mess. Hey, don't worry. Hey, don't worry. I washed my hands last Thursday.
Get some in the picture.
Yeah, get it in the picture. It usually works better that way. All right. Here we go. Now we have our white wine. For those of you who have never opened a bottle of white wine, very important, get the right tools. Okay? This is a waiter's corkscrew. When you buy a waiter's corkscrew, make sure you have five rungs, meaning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If it has four rungs, you're going to be killing a lot of corks. Now, part of a waiter's corkscrew is a knife. Don't use this knife. You'll be cutting things off that you don't want to cut off. Put that away. Okay? So we take this part right here, the sharp end. Very simple. Goes right around and flip it up. Put it right dead center on the cork. And it should be how many twists? Five twists. Leaving the top rung out. And bang, we're done with that. This is a white Pinot Grigio. Along with an apricot brandy. The white Pinot Grigio is about 5 cups, and the apricot brandy is going to be about a half a cup.
If you can open it.
If I can open it.
I'm thirsty over here. No, I want it in there. I opened it.
Oh, we want this in there. It's time to embarrass me. Okay. You know what the sad part is? They're not even drunk yet. All right. There we go. Finally, a little bit of club soda. We want to get a little fizz. We want to get a little party going. And this is going to be about, I'd say about 16 ounces. Very simple, mix it up. Tracks on that one.
Roll the bag.
All right. And a little bit of fruit. My daughter wandered into the room. Say hello, Jess.
Hello.
All right. Alright, moving right along. Let's take a look at our ingredients. First of all, we have shrimp, obviously. This is the star of the show. The shrimp are peeled and deveined. you don't know what that is, we're going to show you one right over here. Now, the whole thing with peeling a shrimp is you have to be in the right mindset, okay? The way I look at it is the shrimp owes me money, okay? Now, when I tell the shrimp, you owe me about 600 clams, I need my scotto. I need my scotto. Now, if you don't know anything about Italian Americans relate money to food. It's a natural combination. 600 clams, what does that mean?
$600.
$600, exactly right. I need my scotto. What's a scotto? Scotto is an Italian lettuce. It generally means?
Lettuce, money.
Money. It means money.
Tip.
Shrimp is telling me, I don't have any money for you. Okay, great. So what we're going to do, the first thing on this shrimp, is we got to rip its legs off. Okay? But you don't want to be prosecuted for it. So the main thing is that here's the key word. Oops. Don't you say oops. They can't prosecute you.
It's all okay.
It was an accident. It was an accident. All right, the legs are gone. Then we take the shell off, and we're going to leave the tail on for this dish. And that's what it's going to look like right there. Okay? We're going to get our pan going.
You take out the schmutz?
Ah, the schmutz. There we go. Here's the legs. Then I take my paring knife. Bring it in, Haley. So I take my paring knife. We just twist the shrimp like this. One simple slice. And then we're going to rinse it off. What are we rinsing off? Some people call it intestines. I don't know. I made up a name for it. You clean out the gonorrhea. There you go.
Oh, now I'm going to eat it.
All right. Here's the star of the show. Bought this yesterday. This is my olive oil container in the shape of a boot, which, of course, is Italy. We're going to go on medium-high heat. Now, the proper way to cook shrimp, when I started learning how to cook 30 years ago, cook shrimp 50% on one side, 50% on the other side. Then I learned my lesson because my shrimp was coming out dry. And the proper way to cook shrimp is 75% on one side, flip it over for about 30 seconds, and they come out perfect. So, the shrimp are already butterflied. Haley wants to come in.
All right.
Then what we're going to do is we're going to season our shrimp.
I don't know where you buy your shrimp, but
where I buy it, it doesn't come seasoned. That's salt, pepper, and granulated garlic. That's it. Okay. Now we can come back here as that's starting off. Okay, so as the shrimp is frying, back to our ingredients. I have 2 cloves of garlic, which need to be sliced. I only slice my garlic because I don't like one of these. This is your handy dandy garlic press. I don't use this because simply the garlic burns because it comes out too small. There'll be a sale after the show. This could be yours for only $45. We take our garlic and we slice it about 1/8 inch thick. Then we're ensured that it will infuse the oil and it won't burn. Secondly, we have fresh parsley. This is Italian parsley, not curly parsley. This came from my garden in my backyard, so I know it's very fresh. That's ready to go. Then we have butter, 1/2 teaspoon of white pepper, 3 ounces of Romano cheese, and 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. I hear my shrimp making noise. I believe they're dancing.
Freshly squeezed.
Everything is freshly squeezed. Even you. All right.
Like I said, 75% cooked on the first side, 25% cooked on the second side, and you can tell when 75% is cooked, the shrimp starts to turn red around the sides, and then we're ready to go. That looks beautiful. You know, this is a time where somebody can make $1 million overnight and invent smell-o-vision. Huh? Our pasta's ready to go. We are at a full boil, and we're at about a pound of the boiler on the pasta. And of course, the first thing we do when we're at a full boil, get about 5 tablespoons of salt and 6 quarts of water. That's ready to go. We set our timer for 9 minutes. And our shrimp is just about there, ready to be turned. Gonna give it another 30 seconds. You know something? I'm so glad I invited you tonight. Okay, we're definitely ready to go. See that? That's about 75% cooked. Another batch? We got another batch.
Now we know how to make it. On the apricot. And we're ready to go. Alright. That's ready to go. Darlene, my favorite sister-in-law, do the honors. Okay. Shrimp is done. We're going to push it off to the side. We're not going to lose any of those juices. Now, we're going to refresh it a little bit with a little more olive oil. We're gonna add our cream. This is a heavy cream, 40% milk fat. All right. Anytime you use fresh herbs, hit it in the sauce early and hit it afterwards. Also, we have a half a tablespoon white pepper. 2 tablespoons of butter. We take our wooden spoon because I don't want to scratch my pen. And at this point, we have a little bit over 5 minutes left. We're going to add our shrimp. And in about another minute, we're going to hit it with Parmesan cheese. Yeah. 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Absolutely. And now it's ready.
It smells so good.
I use Romano cheese in this dish because Parmesan is a little too salty. So this is a Pecorino Romano. Little by little, let's see how it's going to work out.
Did you create that yourself?
Oh, absolutely. Okay. I'm gonna let that cook down a little bit. I have a little bit of cheese in reserve just in case I don't get the right consistency that I want. Always remember that the pasta is also a thickening agent. Okay. A little bit more parsley. A little bit more cheese. I think we are where we want to be. So, like any good cook, give it a taste. It's coating the back of the spoon to the thickness we want. And what I'm really looking for here is the lemon. This is a great song to have on right now. I believe this was the scene of the horse's head. Fortunately, we're not cooking horse tonight.
Normally, ever.
And our pasta is just about ready to go. Okay, we're ready to go. It's showtime. Take a little out over here, make sure we're looking good, which we are. Now, we cooked our pasta about 1 minute short of box directions. Now, of course, we got the old Italian mama strainer. This strainer has been in my family for about 50 years. Try to buy one of these at Home Goods. And we put our pasta in. All right. Okay, we'll bring it back to the stove.
And we're gonna finish it off.
Now, since we cooked our pasta 1 minute short of box directions, this is going to stay in the pan for how long, folks?
1 minute.
There you go. Wow. Bunch of mathematicians in this crowd. Off with the timer. All right. And now we're ready to go to the plate. That looks beautiful.
You're not
going to
get around.
There we go.
That was beautiful.
Finish off with a little fresh lemon.
That is gorgeous.
A touch of olive oil. Extra virgin, of course. And that's the dish.
Yay!
So I want to thank you all for visiting me in my kitchen. Visiting my family, I had a blast. This is the first YouTube video I've ever done cooking. It's a lot tougher than I thought. Now please, like, subscribe, and share from Matt Vecchio Comedy at youtube.com. Now my daughter tells me that you have to hit notification. The notification bell. Okay, this is getting so complicated. When I grew up in Queens, all I did is stick my head out the window and say, "Hey, Joey, look at this video, you moron." And it was pretty simple. Now it's like, subscribe, notification bell.
Share.
And share. Thank you both very much, folks. I had a blast.